Not ovulating or not ovulating regularly is one of the most common causes for infertility. There are a number of causes for ovulation problems. For example, being overweight or underweight can increase the chances of having an ovulation problem. Women with a body mass index, or BMI, under 20 are 38% more likely to have an ovulation problem compared to women with a BMI between 20 and 25. A BMI over 25 or over 30 increases the chances of an ovulation problem by over 30%. If you have a normal BMI, will eating or avoiding certain foods make it more or less likely that you will develop ovulation problems? There is no shortage of so-called experts who will tell you what they think you should eat or avoid. Unfortunately, these recommendations often don't have any scientific evidence to back them up. Several years ago, researchers tried to answer these questions by surveying over 100,000 nurses. Only nurses who were married and had no history of infertility were enrolled in this study. The entire study lasted for 8 years. The researchers would send out a questionnaire every 2 years. The nurses were asked to list what they ate and how often on average they consumed each of the foods and drinks on their list. They were able to show that eating certain foods from certain categories and avoiding others would increase the chance for ovulation problems. First, let's talk about fats. The total amount of fats a person consumed was not linked with ovulation problems. However, trans fats were. Trans fats are typically found in stick margarine, fried foods, and yes, even Girl Scout cookies. Foods produced in the United States are required to list their trans fat content on the package. If trans fats are not listed, look at the ingredients and look for foods that contain partially hydrogenated oils. It only takes about 4 grams of trans fats to interfere with ovulation. That's the amount in 2 tablespoons of stick margarine, 1 medium order of fast food French fries, or 1 donut. What about carbohydrates? This study found that the total amount of carbohydrates in the diet was not connected with ovulation problems. This is extremely important. Women with ovulation problems are frequently told to avoid carbs, but women in the low carb and high carb groups in this study were equally likely to have developed ovulation problems. Next up is proteins. The researchers found that adding 1 serving a day of red meat, chicken, or turkey predicted nearly a 1/3 increase in the risk for ovulation problems. On the other hand, adding 1 serving a day of fish or eggs did not have any impact, but adding 1 serving a day of beans, peas, tofu or soybeans, peanuts or other nuts predicted modest protection against developing ovulatory infertility. Swapping 25 grams of plant protein for 25 grams of carbohydrates shrank the risk of ovulation problems by 43%. Replacing 25 grams of animal protein with 25 grams of plant protein was related to a 50% lower reduction of ovulation problems. Finally, let's talk about dairy products. Women who consumed full-fat dairy had a lower likelihood for ovulation problems. This was not true with low-fat dairy, however. Our Infertility TV bottom line is this: dietary choices do seem to make a difference in whether people will develop ovulation problems. The dietary choices of women who had a lower risk for ovulation problems includes choosing high-fat dairy products and avoiding red meat. Plant-based proteins were better than animal-based proteins, but swapping out carbohydrates for proteins was even better. Infertility TV is your most trusted source for accurate information on infertility and miscarriage. If you are not a subscriber yet, hit the subscribe button right now. A new episode is released every week. Don't miss any episodes. You can also check us out on our website, ivf1.com, where you can become a patient.